Request, why wouldn't this work? This is a classic one, check this out. First, we have a circle with diameter 1, and then we are going to draw a square around the circle. So the perimeter of the square is just equal to 4, because we have 1 on each side. And then we are going to remove the corners. Now notice the shape, we'll still have perimeter equal to 4. And then we're just going to keep on going. If you repeat this process to infinity, it seems like the outside shape will approach the circle, and somehow we can end up with pi is equal to 4 factorial. Why though? First, let's look at this picture. The reason that we end up with pi is because the circle has the circumference pi times the diameter, and the diameter is 1, so the circumference is just pi. The perimeter of the square is just 4. And if you just kind of keep removing the corner and do the thing that you saw in the picture, the process will keep us always have the perimeter equal to 4. Because this portion being right here, this portion being right here, so it's still going to be the same length on the outer portion. But it seems like the outer portion is approaching the circle though, so how come pi is not equal to 4? Unfortunately, here, this procedure will help us to get the area, but not the length. And this is precisely in the arc length formula when you study integration. It has to be done with the square root of all that stuff. Let me show you. Have a look. Let's say we have a piece of the arc or curve, looks like this. And I wanted to find the length from A to B, just like this. This is the formula. And the idea is that you pick a point first, and then you are going to draw a tangent segment, so something like this. Now, this right here, I'm going to call it DL. It's a small portion, just like the change of the arc length. To get the DL, what we'll do is we just go horizontally. This is DX. That's a small change in the X. And then go up vertically, that will be dy, that's a small change in the y, and then we can create a right triangle. And as you can see, by the Pythagorean theorem, we know that dx squared plus dy squared will give us dl squared. And then to isolate the dl, we can just take the positive square root on both sides. So dl equals square root, and then we have the dx square plus dy square. And to get the length, well, let's say we are given that y is a function of x. Then in this case, I would like to factor out the dx squared so that we can have the dx on the outside. And then you'll see this right here is equal to square root, factoring out the dx squared, we will be left with 1 plus this divided by that. Both of them are to the second power. So let's put it as dy dx squared. When you factor out dx squared, you see the dy dx, we can just take the derivative pretty nicely. If you were given x as a function of y, then you factor out dy squared instead. But anyway, so this is the same as dl. Then, this is a product, so we can just split the square root. Square root of this, we just get dx, and I'll put it at the end. This portion stays square root of 1 plus dy dx squared. So this is still the same as dl. Then, to get the length, we'll just have to integrate it. And because we're in dx world, we go from a to b. And ladies and gentlemen, that's exactly the length of this piece of the curve as the integration formula. So the reason that we really have to do like the slanted part like this, like the tangent segment, is so that this procedure will really approach the length of the arc, the piece of curve. Imagine if you just do what we did, like the vertical cut or something like this, like that. What's going to happen is like this. So we still have this portion, and then we go from A to B. If you just draw a horizontal segment from here to here, I don't care how small you draw it. This is just the x. Okay, you have infinitely many of them. If you draw that small like this, you can keep on drawing. Still the x, this tiny bit of change of the x. And guess what? When you add them up, you are in the x world, good. You have a to b, but what are you going to get? It's just the x value. The change of x value, it's in fact just this portion here, the length of that, because you're just adding it horizontally. You're not going to get this arc. So just imagine that you make it like much curved than the circle, then I think this right here is pretty clear. You cannot do like the horizontal thing like that. But anyway, so for this right here, it's a very nice formula to get the length. When you go from A to B, use this formula, it's just B minus A. That will not give us the arc length, unlike this. So if you're talking about the length, do not just do the vertical. You have to make sure it turns slanted. So you will have to use like polygons. You will have to draw like this, 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 this. If you somehow end up with the regular n-gon, then you can find the parameter, and that parameter will approach pi correctly.